So it's time to get a new car, and you also want to drive for Uber and Lyft. But should you buy a new car to drive rideshare? What's up, guys? Your driver Mike here, back with another video. This channel is dedicated to the rideshare space. So if you're a driver, a passenger, or someone just interested in the rideshare space, consider subscribing. So it may be time to just upgrade your car, or your old ones kicked the bucket and it's time to get a new vehicle. Here's what to consider if you also want to drive rideshare. Obviously, the biggest thing with new vehicles is depreciation. That new car is going to depreciate a lot as soon as you drive it off the lot. Now, if you're also driving Uber and Lyft, let's answer a few questions. Number one, how many hours, how many miles do you plan on driving a week? Half of us are part-time drivers and the other half are driving rideshare full-time, and a lot of different criteria go into each when choosing a vehicle. For part-time drivers, you most likely want something with higher gas mileage, but a hybrid is not a necessity, as you also want to consider your own tastes and preferences. A hybrid would be great, but maybe you're looking at other vehicles as well. Make sure it satisfies, of course, the requirements for Uber and Lyft, and also if it can cross platforms. If you have a vehicle that qualifies for Uber X, Uber XL, and maybe even Select or Premium, then you can drive different poles, different parts of the platform, and make more money. So we've considered the gas mileage, we've considered the make of the vehicle as far as driving on different platforms. What else should we think about? We need to think about new versus used. This is the big yin and yang of buying cars for rideshare. Having a new vehicle is great. You can control the maintenance and the upkeep on the car, but again, the trade-off is higher depreciation down the road. With a new vehicle, you may not want to put hundreds and thousands of passengers in your brand new car and potentially get any damages, spills. If we look at used vehicles, other drivers have absorbed some of that depreciation and you get some of those savings. Older vehicles, and we're talking maybe a year to 5 years, are still plenty capable of driving rideshare, but you don't have that large initial investment of a brand new vehicle. Strictly speaking rideshare, a few things that you want to consider. How is the back leg room and the back of the car in general? When passengers get in, is it going to create a welcoming atmosphere and a comfortable ride for your passengers? Strictly speaking rideshare, we really want a car with good ratings on reliability, a car with a good suspension, and a car that's going to last for driving hundreds and thousands of passengers every year. To summarize, guys, we want to look at MPG. We want to look at the miles per gallon and compare engine gasoline versus a hybrid and see if that can go into your decision-making process. We've compared new versus used vehicles. Do we want to make the initial investment up front and consider how much of this driving is going to be for rideshare to get a brand new vehicle? Or can we purchase a vehicle that's within 1 to 5 years, maybe have that depreciation absorbed by another driver and pay a little bit less for not as brand new of a vehicle? We've considered if these cars can be multi-platform on the Uber and Lyft system. Can it cross over from Uber to Uber X or Uber Premium? And lastly, we've considered the aesthetic of the vehicle. How are passengers going to receive your vehicle, and is the back space welcoming and inviting? Anything you can do to encourage tipping. Let me know what I left out and post your comments below about what you guys consider when picking a car to drive for rideshare. Your driver Mike here, I do appreciate you watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe to join the Your Driver team, and I will see you in the next one.